Dear student, due to coronavirus, school started online classes for your study. So you can subscribe Golden Flower Palia YouTube channel, like and press the bell icon.
Hello everyone. So dear class 10th students, today I am here with the lecture number 12 of the class 10th biology. If you will recall your memory, then in the last videos, chapter lecture number 11, we have completed the digestive and the digestion process of the human beings. Today I have taken the topic, that is the next life processes, that is the respiration. Respiration is a very important characteristic of the living organism. This is the very important characteristic of the organism by which an organism survive their life on the earth, right? So now, before the starting respiration, I would like to tell you something. What is the respiration? Generally, what we think, that the inhaling of the oxygen and exhaling of the carbon dioxide, or you can say the taking the air to inside and releasing the carbon dioxide to outside, this is the process of respiration. But biologically, this is not the respiration. It is the part of the respiration which is called the breathing, but this is not the actual definition of the respiration. If you will concentrate, if you will recall your memory about the digestion, we have completed the digestion of the food from the buccal cavity to the small intestine. I mean the complete digestion of food we have studied, digestion, absorption, assimilation. But in that topic, we have not studied the releasing of energy. As you know very well, why we have need of food? Food is, we are having the need of food to get the energy, because food provide us energy. But in the nutrition topic, digestion topic, you have never studied the releasing of the energy from the food, the releasing of the energy from the food, because that is not the part of the digestive system. The releasing of the energy from the food is the part of respiratory system. That is process is called the respiration. So again, I am telling you, the taking air inside, inhaling of the oxygen gas and exhaling of the carbon dioxide gas is not a respiration process. It is the part of respiration which is called the breathing, but it is not the respiration. So what is the respiration? Today I am going to start the process of releasing energy from food is called respiration. It's a very important process. The process of releasing energy from food is called the respiration. So, as you have studied in the digestion of food in the human beings, then in that topic you have studied that food which we have eaten, that is digested in the stomach or small intestine, and that is the absorbed. That process is called the absorption, and the blood transport that food to each and every cell of the body, that process is called assimilation. Now you can say that the process of releasing energy from assimilated food, the process of energy from assimilated food is called the respiration. Assimilated food, which food, the food which is transported each and every cell, means the food which is present in the cell, that is called the assimilated food. The process of releasing energy from food is called the, one more definition you can give here, the process of oxidation, burning of food is called the process of oxidation of food and release energy is called respiration. Is called respiration. The process of oxidation of food and release energy is called respiration. Means when the food is present in the cell and we inhale the oxygen, that oxygen gas is transported to the each and every cell, then that oxygen gas will oxidize the food to the release the energy, that is called the respiration. For example, C6H12O6. This is the formula of glucose and it is the common food which we have in our cells. It is the unit of the carbohydrate. Generally, it represents all kind of the food we are having in diet, like protein, fat, everything is need to digest and release the energy. Protein is not the releasing energy, but C6H12O6 glucose, it takes the oxygen from the environment, means the when we inhale the oxygen, it transport to the cell, then it release the 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus energy. It's a very important reaction of definition. If you will recall your memory, in the first topic nutrition in plants, we have completed the process of photosynthesis. So this is the process which is just reverse, just opposite of the photosynthesis. Respiration process is just opposite to the process of the photosynthesis. Now you can take the example of, just for example, this is your cell. Any cell of your body, like a cell of leg, cell of brain, cell of anywhere cell. Even cells of the respiratory and digestive system of also. So, here food comes in the form of glucose. Food comes here in the form of glucose. Then oxygen comes here, which we inhale. How this food and O2 is transported to the cell? Food is absorbed by the blood, is given after the digestion of the food, is given to the blood. Blood transport the food to the each and every cell. Oxygen is also transported to the each and every cell. How the oxygen gas is transported to the each and every cell, we will discuss in the next topic. Then when these two substances will present here, then they will react together and they will oxidize the food. Oxygen gas will oxidize the food, then the result will be CO2, energy and water. This is the actual representation of the respiration process. This is the actual representation of the respiration process by which you can represent that how the O2 gas is oxidized the food. How the O2 gas, oxygen gas, is oxidizing the food, that process is called the respiration. So I hope this topic is clear to you. Respiration process is not the inhaling and exhaling of the air. It is the biochemical reaction. Now, I will tell you about the two things, that is the breathing and respiration. Both looks that they are very similar. Breathing means the inhaling O2 and exhaling CO2. In the simple words, you can say the inhaling air and exhaling air. Right? In the process of the respiration, the organism inhale and exhale. So that process is called the breathing. Breathing is a part of the respiration process, and breathing is a physical process. Breathing is a physical process. How it physical process? Just for example, look at me. We inhale the air inside the air. Means the air goes to the internal parts of the respiratory system. So we inhale the air and exhale the air. Means the releasing the air to outside. So in this process, inhaling and exhaling, our muscles, ribs and lungs are helpful. But there is no any chemical process is required. No chemical process takes place in this process. That is why this is considered as breathing is a physical process. Breathing is a physical process. Now come on the respiration. Respiration, same definition you can give. The oxidation of food in the cell to release energy is called respiration. Is called respiration. Respiration is a biochemical process. Okay? Physical process. Breathing is a physical process, whereas respiration is a biochemical process. Biochemical process because in this process the different enzymes are used. So due to the utilizing of the different enzymes, this respiration process is considered as the biochemical process. Don't forget, breathing is the part of respiration, but respiration is a whole soul process for releasing the energy. Obviously, without the breathing, respiration is not possible, but whole soul responsibility of the respiration means releasing the energy from the assimilated food is called the respiration process. Now, come on. Next topic is how energy stored. How energy stored means whenever we have eaten the food and the respiration process is going on and the energy is releasing but at that time we don't have need the energy. Means at that time we are not doing any work. Means we don't have need the energy amount. So at that time what will happen? At that time the energy which is produced inside our body by the oxidation of food, by the respiration process, that energy is stored in the form of ATP. Energy is stored in the form of ATP. Now ATP are called energy coins. ATP are called energy coin because the ATP store the energy and at the time of requirement they release the energy. The full form of ATP is adenosine triphosphate. Adenosine triphosphate. How ATP are produced? Production of ATP. production. Production of ATP means energy storing. How the energy storing takes place? The storage of energy. ADP plus phosphate group plus energy. ADP is called adenosine diphosphate. Same definition, same full form will be here, but instead of tri, it will called a di. So adenosine diphosphate plus one phosphate group plus energy, it forms ATP. ATP. They form ATP. Now, this is called inorganic phosphate. Inorganic phosphate. Now, releasing of energy. Just for example, if the person has need, if the person has requirement of the energy to perform the different vital activities, so at the time of ATP, ATP will break down. ATP will break down into ADP plus phosphate group plus energy. So this process takes place in the human beings, not human beings, in all plants and animals. All the procedure is same for the plants and animals. Respiration process is same. ADP plus phosphate group forms ATP. And what are ATP? ATP are the energy coins. ATP are the energy coins. Energy coins means they store the energy. Whatever the energy is releasing by the oxidation of food inside the cell. By the oxidation of food inside the cell, that energy is stored in the form of ATP, that is called adenosine triphosphate. But at the time of energy, ATPs are breakdown to form ADP, and phosphate group plus energy. Now, after this, the very short topic I will take today, that is the types of respiration. Types of respiration. There are the two types of respiration. The first one is aerobic respiration. Aerobic means in the presence of oxygen. The oxidation of food and releasing energy in the presence of oxygen. The oxidation of food and releasing energy in the presence of oxygen is called aerobic respiration. For example, humans, dogs, cats, etc. The largest animal and plants perform the aerobic respiration. For example, C6, H12O6 plus 6O2 is equals to 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus 38 ATP. This is the reaction of aerobic respiration. Now the second respiration, anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic respiration means those organisms which don't have need energy, oxygen gas to release the energy from the food. Means they can get the energy from different chemicals, but they don't have need the oxygen. So, the oxidation of food in the absence of oxygen is called anaerobic respiration. respiration. The examples are bacteria, fungi. In fungi, you can tell about the yeast. Yeast is the best example of the fungus which perform the anaerobic respiration. This reaction you can also write like this. Aerobic respiration you can also write like this. Glucose, two molecule of pyruvic acid. This process is called glycolysis, takes place in cytoplasm. Two molecule of pyruvic acid release 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus 38 ATP. This process takes place in mitochondria in the presence of O2. Means the glucose first will become dissociated into the pyruvic acid. First glucose will dissociate into pyruvic acid, two molecule of pyruvic acid, and two molecule of pyruvic acid will form the CO2 plus 6H2. But in the case of glucose, in the case of anaerobic respiration, C6H12O6, food is directly decomposed, means sorry, dissociated into 6CO2, 6H2O, sorry. In the anaerobic respiration, the products are C2H5OH plus CO2 plus 2 ATP. This is called ethyl alcohol. Ethyl alcohol. Now better concentrate on this. As you can look here, that the end products of the aerobic respiration are CO2 and water, but the end products of the anaerobic respiration are, end products of the aerobic respiration are CO2 and water, and end products are the of the anaerobic respiration are ethyl alcohol and CO2. This same reaction you can also write like this. Glucose in the presence of process glycolysis in cytoplasm. This process takes place in cytoplasm. Then two molecule of pyruvic acid will form, and from the two molecule of pyruvic acid, CO2 H5OH plus 2CO2 plus 2 ATP. Means in anaerobic respiration, a very less amount of oxygen is released. You know very well the ATP are the energy coins. So here the only 2 ATPs are forming, and here 38 ATPs are forming. So in these two types of the respiration, the great difference is, the main difference is energy production. In anaerobic respiration, very less amount of the energy is produced. Anaerobic respiration examples takes in bacteria and fungus, the anaerobic respiration takes place, means they can respire, they can get their energy without the oxygen gas. But in the case of the human beings, the anaerobic respiration is also possible, but at the time of heavy exercise, fast running. Okay, so if the anaerobic respiration takes place in human, if the anaerobic if the anaerobic respiration takes place in the human, then instead of the alcohol, ethyl alcohol, we will form lactic acid. So I will discuss in the next video the anaerobic respiration in the human beings. I hope today's topic clear to you all. In the next video, I will come with you. Till the students, have the more practice, make the proper notes. All the best. God bless you.
Do self-study at home and stay home, save lives. Thank you very much.